I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
Well, Bridget, this is the day you've been waiting for. That is the completion of new subdivision regulations and hopefully the lifting of the moratorium on growth south of I-12. But will it make a difference when it comes to flooding?
Well, Ken, you know, we've said over and over, people who flooded in the past, if you flooded in 83, if you flooded in 16, short of raising your home, there's really nothing that would prevent you from flooding again in the event of one of those catastrophic floods. What we're trying to prevent are people who've never flooded before from being flooded. We're trying to prevent subdivisions from going in and, you know, changing the landscape, filling up property and diverting water to areas where it's never gone before.
Of course, the drainage district's always working, so maybe some of those people, it won't be as bad.
Right. They've done a lot of canal maintenance this year, a lot of cleaning. And the drainage district and the parish council and the administration have all worked together to kind of mesh our requirements so that they complement each other.
Well, I know it's a little complicated, but can you go over some of the things that are in the new and improved subdivision regulations?
Well, two of the big things are the fill ordinance. We're going to cap fill where people can't go in and, like I said, build up property 4 and 5 feet higher than it was prior. We're requiring a 25-foot buffer around developments, so it'll look more like when you're driving down 22 in St. Tammany. You don't see the subdivisions. You see a sign in a wooded area, and it's you know, it still has that country feel, and it doesn't. You don't see the big developments right on the highway.
So will the fill ordinance in particular really make a big difference? Because the concern has been if you raise up this big piece of property, all the ones around it are going to be flooded.
Right. I think it will, Ken. The subdivisions that are already approved and in the works, there's nothing we can do to go back and, you know, change that. We're just looking forward to the future. I think that's a concern with, you know, people continue to see property being built up. They continue to see all these houses being built. And what they don't realize is some of these subdivisions were approved even before our new parish president was in office. So they have made huge strides, you know, over the last 5 years in improving for the future.
We're also, though, hearing from people now on Facebook and elsewhere, they just don't want any new development south of I-12.
They don't. you know, I heard someone make a comment in a meeting a few weeks ago that it was offensive to discuss subdivisions to people over Highway 40. And then someone said even over, like, 190, you know, people don't want to talk about subdivisions north of that, but the people south of you know, the interstate south of 22, they don't want the subdivisions there either. And it you know, it's like an odd phenomenon. You've got people that want to come here because they want to live in the country, they want woods, but then, you know, the more woods that we cut and the more subdivisions we build, we lose the country. So we've got to find that balance to keep what people want to move here for, but still, you know, grow our parish.
You know, it wasn't that long ago, we didn't have really any subdivision regulations in the parish. We didn't have any land use controls at all. That was only a matter of a few years ago.
Right. And tonight we approved our new committees. I actually added a new committee this year. It'll be a land use committee, and we're going to start looking at land use. It may take us a year, it may take us 5 years, but we've got to start somewhere, and you know, I'm excited that we're going to start brainstorming and working towards that.
Well, there was talk of maybe some regulations of shooting ranges coming up.
Well, we did pass those tonight. I think Mr. David and VL and Mr. Bruno both have, you know, discussed that and done interviews. Some of the regulations that we had on the books before were more restrictive than what we've put in place now. But it was just a lot of housekeeping that needed to be done. And we actually had two people sit on the committee who are, you know, really big into shooting and really involved in NRA shooting. And we had several men who do the concealed carry classes look over the ordinance, and they all felt very comfortable with what we were passing.
Also, over the weekend, you were able to go out to the Tangipahoa River and look at the oil spill that has caused a lot of concern. But you know, let's hope that it works out okay. It doesn't appear to have done a tremendous amount of lasting damage. We'll know soon.
Yeah, I actually did not go out there. I was sent pictures and videos. I had gotten a call, I think it was Friday morning, from a concerned resident, and they meet. So I reached out to the administration and to our emergency operations manager, and they had already notified all of the proper agencies. I think the EPA and DEQ were involved, and the Louisiana State Police Hazardous Division. So I heard it was a tremendous amount of oil that had went into the river, and it traveled quite a ways to get to the river from the original source. So I'm just hoping they're able to get it cleaned up. I know it made it down as far as 40 from what I have heard.
You know, you go back to the Scenic Rivers Act, which was implemented in the early 70s, and at that time the ecological threats to the river were from the timber industry and gravel. But now we have a new type of threat, which is namely just civilization getting so close to the river.
Right. Yes, it's building up closer and closer, and you know, we've got businesses coming in, we've got a lot of things that are, you know, potentially harmful to the river.
So at some point, I mean, I think we need to look at that again and, you know, craft a state law or a parish ordinance that meets the needs of now, not what was going on 50 or 60 years ago.
Right. We need to do that with a lot of things, you know, look, you know, bring our parish up to date, bring it up to 2021. Another thing that we're looking at is updating our master plan. That's actually something that our parish planning commission is tasked with doing. And I've talked to Mr. Jack Gautreau, who is the president of the planning commission, and he's already talked to several people in administration, and this is something that he feels is necessary too. So I look forward to working with him to update our master plan, and that'll kind of work hand in hand with our land use that we're going to start looking at.
And you just had another litter pickup.
We could pick up litter every day and never catch up, Ken. It's just amazing. You know, I live right by a high school, and I go out on Sunday afternoon. I try to go maybe every 2 to 3 weeks and pick up, and I'll pick up my, just, you know, a little area in front of my house, and the next day there's paper cups and just mask. You know, it's unreal what people throw out the window.
Well, plus, I mean, I hear that on some of these roads, I guess it's a joke that you could furnish a house, but there are sofas and old refrigerators, you name it.
It's not a joke. There are furniture, we found toilets, you know, anything that people don't want to have to worry about disposing of, they just throw it out the window.
But I have to ask the question, are we making any progress?
Ken, I think we are, and I've said this before. You know, what people don't realize, the trash in the ditch, when we have heavy rains, that's carried down and it gets into our rivers, it gets into the lake. And so if we can catch it and stop it before it gets into those water bodies, because I can tell you, I would love for people who, if you're a litter bug, please do not throw the trash as far as you can throw it. Throw it right outside your window, because when we're picking up trash, we've got to jump ditches and go up in the woods sometimes to grab things. So the further it gets off the road, the harder it is for us to retrieve it.
By the way, for the people who want to help in your efforts, what should they do?
Well, we have a website. It's on our Tangipahoa Parish Government page. We have a special tab. We've actually been working on it, kind of rebranding our litter. We have a new logo, and I'm not 100% sure if that is live. I know it's live for us to look at it, the ones that are working on that. But they can go on there and sign up to volunteer. You can make donations, and we're still working on revamping a lot of that. We're kind of reformulating our litter board. The parish councilman will be appointing people to that board. So anyone who's interested in serving, please reach out to us if you want to, you know, serve on that board, or if you want to have a cleanup in your area, we would love to come out and help you with that.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.